Many people gathered today to remember those who gave their lives for our country. Aboard the USS North Carolina, hundreds came out to honor the fallen. Our Caitlin Stansel was there. And Caitlin, you talked to veterans and Senator Richard Burr, who was one of the speakers at this event.
Well, actually, standing on board a vessel that is a true reminder of the sacrifices our service members make every day. We talked to Senator Burr about our role as a country in helping our veterans transition back into society after war and get the care they need to lead successful lives once they're out of service.
The average American should be embarrassed at how pitiful the Veterans Administration is, at the hoops they make our veterans jump through, the difficulty that veterans have at getting the services that they so richly deserve. The fact is that I think most Americans, though, and we've seen this over the past 14 years with the current conflicts, see a person in uniform and go out of their way to thank them.
He says there's still much to be done, and we've seen some efforts here in our area with the Veterans Amnesty Day at the courthouse a few weeks ago, and even in Raleigh, the governor right now working on creating a Department of Military and Veteran Affairs on the cabinet level. In the studio tonight, Caitlin Stansel, Fox Wilmington News.
Caitlin, we were also able to speak to Senator Burr about what it meant for him to participate in this 50th annual Memorial Day observance. He says veterans are the reason we have the freedoms we have today. He also talked about, we also talked to a few others there about what this day means to them.
I have several people, you know, in my past that were submariners and fought and died for their country just so that I could come up and grow up and do the same thing for my family.
Memorial Day for me means freedom. This is why we're Americans.
It's a remembrance of all the real winners and people that I acknowledge, because the real heroes aren't here today.
It's such a great honor and privilege to be an American, and I hope folks have taken time today to reflect on those who gave the ultimate sacrifice.
Well, I'm sorry they had to go, but they know they're glad to have given their lives to know that we have freedom.